Taiwan begins administering its first domestically developed COVID-19 vaccine. First to get the shot, Taiwanese President Tsai Ing-wen, in a bid to demonstrate the vaccine's safety, amid objections, the approval process was rushed. Taipei approved the emergency use of Medigen's COVID-19 shot last month as part of a broader plan for vaccine self-sufficiency in light of delays in deliveries from global drug firms. More than 700,000 people have so far signed up to receive the Medigen vaccine. The shot was developed in collaboration with the National Institutes of Health in the U.S. Overseas, the Delta variant outbreak in New Zealand grows. The country reported 35 new cases Monday, taking the total number of infections in its current outbreak to 107. 33 of those cases were recorded in Auckland, while the remaining two were in Wellington. The rise in cases forced Prime Minister Jacinda Ardern to extend New Zealand's national lockdown until Friday, except for Auckland, which will be under lockdown until the end of the month. Ardern also suspended Parliament for a week, warning the current outbreak has not peaked yet. The Philippine Health Department says the community transmission of the more contagious Delta variant is already being observed in Metro Manila and the Calabarzon region. But it stressed the need for more evidence to declare outright that there is community transmission of the variant. Based on the World Health Organization's definition, community transmission is when large numbers of cases can no longer be linked to transmission chains or that there are multiple unrelated clusters in several areas of a country.
Dito sa NCR, nakita natin yung biglang pagtaas ng mga kaso at saka pagtaas nung nade-detect natin na Delta variant. So the assumption is there, lahat ng action natin ay geared towards that level of community transmission already. But as to confirming it, kailangan kasi namin ng ebidensya. Currently, we have seen and observed, no, especially in NCR and Region 4A, na talagang mukhang community transmission na ito. Nakita natin na wala nang link ang mga kaso sa bawat isa. We are seeing clustering of cases in these two big regions. Kaya iyan po ay isang bagay na pinagtutuunan natin ng pansin sa ngayon. Definitely, I can tell all of you, Region 4A and NCR na andyan na po. No? We can observe that already, although we need further evidence.
The Philippines has so far recorded 807 Delta variant cases. The variant has been detected in nearly all regions in the Philippines except Caraga. The ongoing spike in COVID-19 cases this August has already exceeded the previous peak in April this year. Data from the health department show the number of average daily reported cases in the Philippines was at around 14,300 from August 16 to 22. That's higher than the average of 10,400 cases reported from March 29 to April 4.
It is probable na magkaroon pa tayo ng higher peak. But again, the numbers can change depending on what we will do, no, and what we have been doing.
Meanwhile, the capacity at intensive care units across hospitals in Metro Manila is now under high-risk classification. Health Undersecretary Leopoldo Vega says of the nearly 1,300 ICU beds in the National Capital Region, 73% are currently occupied.
You have to take a look at the COVID cases that we have, and we're seeing roughly about almost 98% mild, moderate, and asymptomatics. We've seen a numbers of 1.86 for the severe and critical. This is kind of different from what we saw in April and last year, where it was hovering around 3% for the severe and critical. With this 1,245 ICU that we have right now, can cover the 1.86 severe and critical patients that we have. But of course, if the numbers will still go up, then we will have to find out and sort out and align our hospital beds for this COVID patient.
Roughly 70% of active COVID-19 cases in the National Capital Region are unvaccinated individuals. Metropolitan Manila Development Authority Chairman Benhur Abalos says the unvaccinated make up more than 15,000 of the 21,000 active infections in NCR.
Look at the death, look at the critical, and look at the severe. these data will speak for themselves that really it's very important to get vaccinated.
Meanwhile, Abalos says 7 to 8% of senior citizens in NCR have already been fully vaccinated. 41% of individuals with comorbidities have also received their second dose.